Donald Trump photo creating a social media firestorm. He's eating KFC with a knife and fork, man, went one typical comment after Trump tweeted this photo taken on his private jet. There's chicken on his plate, containers of mashed potatoes and gravy, and he's about to dig in with a knife and fork. You'll remember Trump was mocked when he ate pizza with a knife and fork with Sarah Palin when they went out to eat in 2011.
Black people, white people, Asian people, Indian people, all kinds of people. We're all the same, right? Wrong.
We're here at a KFC in Manhattan to find out if customers really use a fork and a knife when they eat their fried chicken. What do you make of Donald Trump eating fried chicken with a knife and a fork?
I feel stupid.
See that little bit of meat right there, Matt? Mmm. There you go. When you're done, go back to your little bones part in here. Dip it in some sauce. Don't let Neil tell me you fucked that chicken off again.
This looks so good.
Yeah. Ooh. This looks delicious.
I love burgers.
Me too.
I can eat them for every meal.
Mm-hmm.
What did you do to my burger?
Put some ketchup on it.
Just put some ketchup on it. You destroyed it.
I'm Josh Capon, the four-time Burger Bash champion of the world, and I'm going to show you how to eat a burger.
You don't eat a burger with a fork and knife.
It's more like a burger salad.
No, but that's an absolute monstrosity. Then we got to start from scratch.
If you come to this channel, you're going to see me grubbing. That's what's going to happen here. So don't fucking, if you're not used to seeing people eat, this is an eating show channel, okay? Let's just get that clear right now, okay? Clear that shit up. I'm gonna eat.
Mayor de Blasio today in Goodfellas Pizza on Staten Island, when he dug into a slice with a knife and fork. No hands, at least not at first. Pictures of the mayor eating pizza with utensils, getting mocking comments today on social media. The mayor, though, defended himself, saying he ate it the way they do in his ancestral homeland of Italy.
She hate lanes. All grown up in your hate games. I remember the first time we was out of state. Should have seen your face. 200 on the.
Mama, this is good.
Pizza with a fork and a knife at Gino's Pizzeria in Queens.
The pizza came scalding hot, okay? And so I use a little fork. You know what my wife, who's on a spring break with my daughters, you know what she said? I'm proud of you. You finally learned how to use a utensil properly.
Lord, have mercy.
because it's called the heart. You know, it makes me feel so bad sometimes when I see my black brothers and sisters, and they'll see me eating a piece of watermelon like this, yeah. And they'll go to frown their faces on me, that's despicable. But it's good. And you know the thing that makes me mad? When I go to their parties, they will take a big, pretty watermelon like this and cut all kinds of gadgets. And then cut the inside. You see this good piece of watermelon here? Cut all the guts out that good watermelon and mix it up and mess it up with something else, man. And sometimes they got a notion to put liquor in it. And then after they cut them little crevices in it, then put it back inside of that hub. Man, that's a waste of watermelon when all you got to do with it is pick it up like this here. Look here, just pick it up like this here. I don't mess this up. I ain't whack a buck my eye there. Well, lay back. That's the way you eat a watermelon. And I don't care if you're a PhD, if you're a whatever. You can't tell me cutting all that out, putting it back in there. Hello. Miss Betty is here. Now, I know you're sitting home. That's an ignorant nigga. But this is a sweet watermelon. I ain't gonna waste no time cutting no watermelon up and mix it up with no food cocktail.
You can't eat a rib with a knife and fork. You gotta go in there. You gotta go in there. When you're eating a rib, you gotta go in there. You gotta go in there with your head, You gotta take your hands and you gotta go in there. You can't eat it with a knife and fork. It just ain't gonna happen.
So I'm gonna teach you how to eat ribs like a black man. So I just came from your local Gold Street Market and I just bought me some ribs. Look at these motherfuckers right here. Good as hell, huh? So I'm about to open them up.
My old Please. Boy from the point, but I'm from Southwest.
Delicious. So I'm gonna teach you something, though. You crack them up, fuck open. Get it, man.
But I got my food. Didn't come for no beef, cause I don't eat steak. I got a plate of soul food, chicken, rice, and gravy. Not covered in too much, drinking a cup of punch. Topical every last Thursday of the month.
Bro, the fat one is real. It's good, though. I gotta clean that bone. Look at that. Not done yet. Who's that tea, you know? Get that. What God gave us team for? We gotta use it. Get that meat off that bone. Yeah. How I do it, you know? Get the next one, you know? Get that slap. I know a lot of people, they need napkins and shit. So I take my hand. You don't need no napkin. It's too civilized. Some big back ribs. Yeah. I'm not a big rib fan, but when I eat ribs, I tear down some ribs. Medium. And also, remember, nice one, get it? Use those two teeth down here. Scrape that bone. When you're done? Clean hands. Yeah. No napkins. Little sanitary napkins. Little white shit. Niggas do it like this.
Excuse me, but that's not how you eat a burrito. Don't do is use an knife and fork.
Britain's Prime Minister David Cameron has been skewered in the middle of a tense election campaign for eating a hot dog with a knife and fork.
What?
You're going to be dipping soup from 12 o'clock on the face of that clock. The outermost spoon is going to be your soup spoon, and as you see, it's a utensil with a larger bowl. You'll know it's the soup spoon because it's to the far right side. Remember, anything above your plate setting is for dessert, so you're not inclined to pick up that dessert spoon thinking that might be the first course. Soup spoon on the outside on the right. I am going to dip soup from 12 o'clock in my plate. I will take the soup spoon across the edge of the plate, gets any spills off the bottom of the soup spoon, and then the soup comes up to me. I'm going to drink the soup from the edge of the spoon that faces me, not from the point of the spoon.
What?
One was crying and I want to know who it was.
Well, it's a long story, okay? But my stupid friend Jerry told my other friend Noreen that she was... Hey, you want to hear something weird? Mr. Pitt eats his Snickers bars with a knife and fork.
Really?
Yes.
Why does he do that?
He probably doesn't want to get chocolate on his fingers. That's the way these society types eat their candy bar.
What the hell are you doing?
I am eating my dessert. How do you eat it? With your hands?
He's kind of a baritone, isn't he? What are you doing? I'm eating this cookie.
No, but why are you using a knife and a fork? Did you just think of that?
No, I've seen people do it. I like it.
Here's your knife and fork.
Look, she's cutting up an almond joy.
I just don't get it.
You know, I saw someone on the street eating M&Ms with a spoon.
What is wrong with everybody?
Look, they're doing it. They're all doing it.
What is wrong with all you people?